गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई ऑलरेडी बिगन द पोयम आफ्रिका फॉर द क्लास 9th स्टैंडर्ड. सो आई ऑलरेडी टॉट यू 12 लाइन्स आई थिंक. सो स्टूडेंट्स, हु रोट दिस पोयम? डेविड डियोप. ही इज़ ए फ्रेंच writer, Afro-French writer. He lived only 33 years. It's a most popular poem. I already told you that this poem originally written in French language, but it gets translated to English. So I explained all these things. So if suppose this poem, if it is in a French version, how the song will be, how the song is in French language, let me read it for you. Africa mono Africa, Africa des pyres guerisa densa lensa savannas ancestralas, Africa comi chatteri Ma Granda Mera, other border days and plenty Ronita, Africa my mono Africa. So this is French language. I don't like to read that song. Let me read the song which is in English. Africa my Africa. Here poet has got lot of attachment towards his Africa. He tells Africa, then he tells my Africa. He got attachment towards it. My Africa, why he is telling? Because he got some attachment. Okay, Africa of proud warriors in ancestral savannas, Africa of whom my grandmother sings. See, he came to know about Africa through his grandmother's singing of ballads. Perhaps she was singing the ballads of great warriors of the savannas of Africa. Savanna is a grassland. In the savanna grassland, we are able to see that lions are moving, and the Africans were used to fight with them, and sometimes they killed even the lions, by fighting with their open hand. So that showed that they were the great warriors. So therefore he feels proud about the warriors of his ancestral savannas. He came to know about those warriors through grandmother's singing. On the banks of the distant river, here he says, my Africa lies in the distant land or faraway land, because he was living in France. For him it was a far away. And I have never known you, he says. I have not never seen you, but still I am having attachment towards you, because through my grandmother I came to know about my ancestral land. That way he feels proud about his Africa. Next. But your blood flows in my veins, your beautiful black blood that irrigates the fields, the blood of your sweat, the sweat of your work. Here he says, the African blood flows in me, because he says, I belong to the same race of the blacks. He considers that black blood as a beautiful blood, because that blood irrigates the fields, that irrigated the fields of America. America became very rich country because of the hard work done by the Africans there. The blood of your sweat, the sweat of your work, he says, The people of Africa, they worked hard in such a way that they converted their sweat as a blood, and because of their hard work, European and American countries progress. Okay, the countries of Europe and America progress because of the hard work done by the Africans. Okay, we come to the next page. The work of your slavery, the slavery of your children. There he says, but how they work? They work 14 to 16 hours a day, as like, okay, without rest. See, even proper payment was not made for their work. Proper rest was not given them. Both children and elders of black race worked as slaves under whites, and he feels very sorry for it. Okay, I hope till there I taught you during last video, isn't it? And let me continue today. Okay, Africa, tell me, Africa, is this bag that is bent, this bag that breaks under the weight of humiliation? See, humiliation means dishonor. Okay, Africa, see, the poet directly addresses Africa. Africa here means the people belongs to black race. That thing also you can take into consideration. Africa, tell me, Africa, okay, you want to remain your back always bent down, slaves always bent down before their master. You want to remain as a slave continuously. This back that breaks under the weight of the humiliation. See, your back get break down under the weight of humiliation. See, when the whites humiliated, your back get broken down. This back trembling with red scars. Here, when the whites exploited you, your back was trembling and it had got lot of red scars on it. Scars means wounds. And saying yes to the whip under the midday sun. See, when the whites, when they were ruling, when they were had domination, they took work from this black people even under the midday sun by beating whip, by using some whip. They took work from the Africans. So, okay, but a grave voice answers me. See, the ancestral, the voice is grave because the ancestors of the blacks suffered a lot due to that slavery system. Okay, that grave voice answers to me means here to the younger generation of the black people. Impetuous son, that tree young and strong, that tree there. Okay, impetuous means, you may be quick, son. Today's younger generation Africans, okay, they are like young tree and strong tree. See that tree there, the splendid loneliness amidst white and faded. See, there is a tree. Okay, the tree called Africa, that is grand. Even though you standed alone, okay, in the midst of white and faded flower. See, he tells, after that colonial rule, most of the African countries got freedom, okay, and the white people became like a faded flower. Okay, today they don't have any importance. So, in the environment of freedom. Today, after the colonial rule get end over, now Africa has to grow under the atmosphere of freedom. So that is Africa, your Africa, that grows again patiently, obstinately. The poet wants Africa should grow again with a lot of patience, with stubbornly, obstinately means stubbornly, okay, without giving up the spirit of growing. It must again should grow, and its fruit gradually acquires the bitter taste of liberty. See, even though that liberty which Africa gained, gained by hard struggle, its fruit may be having the bitter taste, because the African history has got the bitter taste of slavery, isn't it? So they cannot totally forget. Totally, they cannot forget the bitterness they undergone during the rule of colony. I hope you understood this poem. So he tells, Africa, tell me Africa. Okay, let me repeat what I told you today. So he personifies Africa. He thinks Africa as a person. That means he addresses the Africa of today. Okay, so you want to remain as like the slave during the time of whites rule, or during the time of colonial masters rule. So is this back that is bent, means you want to remain your back bent, or this back that breaks under the weight of humiliation, still you want to remain as broken down your back due to the humiliation, this back trembling with red scars. See, once upon a time when whites were ruling, at that time your back was trembling with lot of red wounds. So, and they took work, even waiting under the midday sun. So that was the situation. Those lines reflect the sorry situation of the slavery of the blacks during the colonial rule. Okay, but a grave voice answers me. But today, even though they suffered, the blacks suffered, the grave voice, the sorrowful voice of their ancestors answers me, impute your son, that tree young and son, young and strong, that tree there. See here, Africa is like a tree. Okay, its branches may be cut down by the white trees, but today it has a chance again to become young and strong. Okay, that tree there, see here, there is a tree there, it is still young and strong. The splendid loneliness, even though it is lonely there, but it looks very grand amid white and faded flowers. See here, that tree is there, it is in between the white and faded flowers. Okay, there are surrounding it with white and faded flowers. White and faded flowers means whom? The people belongs to the white. Today, white people have become like a faded flower. Okay, that's here. So now, in the atmosphere of freedom, Africans have got a chance to grow again. So that is Africa, your Africa, that grows again patiently, obstinately. Here, what is this? In the atmosphere of freedom, let my Africa, he wishes, my Africa means my African people should progress patiently by having the stubborn quality. Okay, they should not give up, okay, even though they suffered. And its fruits gradually acquire the bitter taste of liberty. See, so even though Africans got freedom, okay, still the fruits that they that the fruit of that liberty, still it is bitter because of that memory of slavery system their ancestors had undergone. Okay, I think you have understood this poem, but let me tell something to you. Every person in this world is proud about his roots, that means proud about his ancestors. For example, when Obama became the president of America, okay, he was the first person to become the first Afro-American, means the person who belongs to the black race to become the president of United States of America. I hope you know that it is the most powerful post in the world, isn't it? American president means it is like he is like the king of the whole world, isn't it? So when Obama became the president of America, Siddhis of North Kannada district of Karnataka, they are also belongs to African race. They became very happy about it. They celebrated in their environment, because one Afro, the person belonging to their race had become the president of the USA, the most powerful person in the world. Okay, so see here, everybody has got some kind of proud. Okay, they develop some kind of respect toward their heritage. Okay, V.S. Naipaul, you know that he was a great writer. He was born in one of the islands of West Indies. Later on, he got a Nobel Prize for writing something in literature. Then V.S. Naipaul's forefathers are from India. See here, then he felt attachment towards India. He visited India, and after that he wrote some books related to India. So see here, even though he was not a resident of India, but his ancestors belong to India, therefore he had attachment towards India. So like that, see here, everybody has got some attachment toward their roots. I hope this poem, David Diop, even though he was in France, he had attachment towards his Africa. I hope you understood this poem. You write this poem 2 times, and this is enough today, and good day.